Hello homies, and welcome back in the shop for a second time this week, hopefully. I mean, I still have to edit this together. A quick CNC project today. If you watched the last video uploaded a few days back, you will already know that I am kinda in the process of making a 3D printer. If not, so this 3D printer, when it's done, I intend to run on Marlin, which I already know a bit and which I love, to be honest. First of all, it works great for me for over a year now. But apart that, there's also the remoto, which in a funny way managed to speak to my cold and quite technical heart. Here it goes. Brought to you with love, lack of sleep, and lots of coffee. And don't get me wrong, I still have huge respect for all the open source guys out there, making firmware, CAD/CAM programs, GUI hosts, music, machines, operating systems, you name it. Today it is about Marlin. So, tweaking Marlin in the process of making the printer, I came across a feature that I intended to try on our router for a long, long time now. And you know what? Finally, it is time. So as we said already when making this, running Marlin, which is a 3D printer firmware, on a milling machine like this one, gives you some very nice little extras. The biggest one of them all is that this machine having an LCD screen, a button here, and an SD card reader is now completely standalone. This means that you can operate it as is by just plugging it to the wall, and without using a computer. There. The second thing that I find extremely handy is the live feed rate adjustment. So while I'm already into my operation, if I decide I want to speed things up a bit, I just turn this knob. And everything is now twice the speed. Then there is the fact that it is displaying the machine's position constantly, machining times, a percentage of the job already completed, all sorts of stuff. And then there is this thing that we are gonna talk about today. Bed leveling. Here is how it goes. With those machines, you usually want your bed to be leveled. This means that it has to be perpendicular with X and Y on both directions. In other words, if your tool is just touching the bed here, it should be also just touching the bed back there without adjusting your Z height. And this is a thing that you pay attention to when making this machine in the first place, but have a look here. A scrapboard over a scrapboard over a scrapboard. It is highly possible that you're gonna end up using this scrapboard technique over time to compensate for different material thicknesses and different cutting tool lengths. Especially for machines like this one, where the Z travel is not too big. And besides that, it's always handy to have a scrapboard mounted up there so that you can secure your work by just screwing it without messing too much with your machine's bed. Of course, with this machine being a router, it is not that much of a problem. You can always use the machine itself to make a facing cut every time you use a new scrapboard, making sure that it's gonna be level. But this of course requires some effort, some time, and you know, it makes dust. Besides that, this may not always be the case. There may be situations where you want to make an even cut, depth-wise, on an uneven surface, engraving something like the back of a plate, as an example. This thing you could usually compensate for when designing your G-code, but with this feature we're using today, it's gonna be much faster and much easier. Trust me. We are getting there, I promise. When using a 3D printer, it is also very critical that your printer's bed is level. In fact, it is even more, as if it's not the case, your first layer printed may not stick on the bed, and your whole print may move at any given time. And then you are quite screwed. Also, 3D printers cannot mill stuff. So if your bed is crooked, the only thing you can do pretty much hardware-wise is adjust it by using the four screws they usually have, one on each corner. But what if you have a low-end printer that doesn't have an adjustable bed? And here is where we come to the case, and I stop rambling around. Inside Marlin there is a function called bed leveling, and what this does is that it compensates for every tilt, flex, or wrap you have on your machine's bed. So if you have a bed that is crooked this way, it makes your whole operation crooked to match your nasty bed. The principle is quite simple here, but quite effective also. The first step is scanning your bed in a way, height-wise. This is achieved by sending your spindle to 9 or more different locations on this bed and lowering Z until your tool is just touching your machine's bed. Then Marlin uses those 9 or more different points to create a mesh that matches your bed's upper surface. This procedure can be done automatically by using a probe on your Z-axis, some kind of sensor that defines if you are touching your bed or not, or it can also be done manually, which requires next to nothing and which you are about to see right now. I am exaggerating a bit just to make it more clear. So my new bed is now definitely crooked, with the left side here being higher than the right one by what, 10-15 mm. And now we're gonna run a leveling routine on that. But first we have to enable it inside Marlin. Which is pretty simple. For our case, where we're gonna use manual bed leveling, you just go under your configuration tab and you scroll down to Z probe options, where you define probe manually. Then you go a bit lower into this tab and you also define mesh bed leveling, and a bit lower to define LCD bed leveling. Also, I like to tweak those numbers to give me more accuracy for finer Z adjustments and a bigger range of movement to adjust Z on each one of the 9 spots. And that's pretty much it. We are ready. Except for one thing. In order to run a leveling cycle, we first need to auto-home the machine, XYZ, so that it knows where it stands. But this requires having limit switches on all 3 axes. X and Y are not a problem, as we have them installed already, but we have nothing on the Z. Now this is a bit controversial if you ask me. Requiring an end stop on the Z axis in order to run a manual leveling cycle. But luckily, the solution is pretty simple. I just used one of those little jumpers to sort my Z positive end stop. My Z homes in the positive direction. This way I trick the machine into believing that I have an end stop up here on my Z, which is always triggered. And if you remember to auto-home your machine every time you power it on, it should not cause you any problems. But now we are ready. Words would be rubber if actions were glue. Slightly left of the heightened, frightened children building millions of billions. Half-assed new, like the slippery distant crystal sea, like the birds on a tree. The home in the sky is likely to die. So what did you see back there? After auto-homing the machine, I chose to run a leveling cycle. So the spindle was lifted a bit, it traveled to the first point, bottom left corner of our new table, and went back down a bit. There I used the encoder to lower my spindle until my tool was just pressing onto that piece of paper, while the machine was keeping track of how much my Z had traveled. Once it was touching, I pressed the encoder, the spindle lifted and moved to the next location. This thing I repeated 8 more times, until I got a message on the screen, leveling done. And I heard that funny sound. Which means our new leveling is stored on our controller's EEPROM to use anytime. And now, have a look on this one.
move like a move of a whale. It's shot right up, but got caught in our sail. Sailed ever faster towards land with my master plan. Establish a relationship with a clan. What? Oh, simply infinity, proximity of soul, aphrodisiac in the center of it all. Rules imitate in the Zulu nation. When Zuma die, then we be confused with the Haitian. Yes, sir.
And there you have it. Now this piece of code, if you have a look at it, it is an ordinary case, as if we were about to carve it on a flat piece of stock. 0.6mm depth of cut across the whole thing. But as we said, Marlin made it crooked to match our crooked bed. And that's all it takes. Just one more thing. In order to use the last bed leveling settings that you have stored in your machine, you need to add two more commands on the top of your G-code file.
501 here is to load all your settings from your controller's EEPROM, and M420S1 here turns on the leveling function for the following G-code.
So there is a ton of different options and possibilities this feature provides for us, like auto-leveling using all sorts of different switches, or as I said, engraving on complex surfaces using nothing but a flat piece of G-code, and so on. But those are maybe for another time. Until next time, thank you all for being here, and have a nice one.